All right, so we are here for the PSL, the Pumpkin Spice Workout. I got my shirt on to match it today. But of course, it doesn't stand for Pumpkin Spice Latte. For the workout, it stands for Push / Plank, Squat, and Lunge. So we've got three rounds of 8 minutes each. The first round is going to be about 8 minutes of pushing movements and planking movements. Second one is going to be squatting movements. Third round is going to be lunging movements. You are going to want one set of dumbbells for some chest presses, and then a single dumbbell for the squats. But other than that, it's going to be completely body weight. So let's go ahead and throw on some music here and let's get warmed up. So go ahead and start with those lateral lunges, just moving side to side, getting our bodies a little bit warmed up. I can't just say I'm going. Got like a bunch of little warnings. It's dangerous. Either pass tall through center or stay low. Bring it all the way down for a little bit of inner thigh. Take any rotation that's necessary. Everybody here today knows what their body needs as far as a warm-up position. We're going to take about 30 more seconds to just get set. All right, so we're going to start with our standard elbow wide push up. As always, options to take it on your knees, take it on an elevated surface, take it in a four-point stance, extended stance, whichever works better for you. We're starting in three, two, here we go. Standard push-ups. No matter where you are, on your knees, on your feet extended, up in a four-point position, keeping that core in and tall, and those elbows at a 45-degree angle from the body is the most important. And rest. We are going to narrow push up next. So the goal is to get those elbows to be skinning your body. And here we go. I'm going to take 4-point stance on this one because my shoulder has not been loving this week. If yours is more extended out, it's the same motion, just keeping those elbows hugging the body. We have 10 more seconds right here. And rest. Next, we are taking a staggered stance push-up. So one arm is going to be forward. The forward arm is going to be external. The near arm is going to be internal. And then switch.
So, switching hands every time you're in the up position. The back arm is hugging your body. The forward arm is pressing out to the side. Again, feet, 4-point stance, elevated. Five more seconds. And rest. We're moving up into downward dog. The goal is to move the head towards the ground from the down dog position. Here we go. Back should be flat, bending your knees as much as necessary. Elbows push out to the sides. And rest. Coming down onto your back for chest presses. Grabbing those weights. And here we go. Feet may either be down or lifted to add a little more core. Your choice. Tuck your shoulder blades down underneath your back. Bringing the weights up to sternum height. They should not be up by your chin or face. They should be down at your sternum. Bra line for those who wears ones. Wear ones? What's that? And rest. Rolling it back over for our plank sequence. We only have 3 more minutes on letter P today. Standard neutral plank. Elevated on your feet, down on your knees, wherever works best. Coming down to elbow. Squeezing those glutes and quads, not just your core. We have 10 more seconds right here. Take a quick break in downward dog if you need to, and then hop right back into that hold. And rest. Coming in for our right side plank, right hand or elbow is down, feet either extended or knee posted underneath. Here we go. Arm may be up at your hip, side supported, just working for a straight line with that body. Legs may be stacked. Slightly more stability forward and back. 10 more seconds. Oh, I lied. That was 20 more seconds. Keep it going. Make any adjustments as needed. Now we are done. Take a rest and move it to the other side. And here we go. You want to add a little motion to it? Be my guest. Twenty more seconds. Final five. 10, you're done. Bringing it up to stand. We have a wide to narrow squat. Here we go. Narrow, step wide. Trying to keep your torso long, not crunching in. Final five. And rest. We have squat jumps next. Option to take flight at the top or just push tall onto your toes. Here we go. And rest. We're opening up wide for a brown plie with a right heel lift. So squat down with it lifted. Press tall and lower. Here we go. Knees pressing open. Tailbone sitting down to the ground. Final five. And rest. Squat jack is next. So either adding the jump together or pull in one side, pull in the other side. Here we go. Final 15. And rest. Round plie with left heel lift. Oh, Open those knees wide. You may leave it up the whole time if you prefer. I prefer to drop on the stand. And rest. Like a small boat. Two more minutes on the squats, then we move on to the lunges. We're going to go single leg squat. Weight is completely on the left foot. Simply kickstand out that right foot. Sit down. Stand up. Spine stays long. Hovering is an option, but not unnecessary. Using it for balance, as long as 95% of the weight is on the left foot. See about sitting back and reaching for a chair. And rest. We have the opposite side. And then we move on to lunges. And here we go. Always an option to find something to use for balance. And the depth of the motion really doesn't matter. It is the intention and the balance that we're going for. And rest. First round of lunges. Left leg is staying stationary. Right leg forward lunge. Here we go. Push back, stand up. Goal is torso to stay tall, moving towards a 90 degree on the back leg. Front knee, never moving over the toes, staying back towards the heel. This is my fight song. Take back my life song. Move and move my song. And rest. Opposite side. In five. Here we go. Tuck that tail under, torso is lifted. And rest. Curtsy to lateral. You may use the optional pressing weighted arm. I am choosing not to today. It's up to you. Here we go. Left foot is planted. Right foot is your mover. If you're doing the press, it's on the curtsy, and then you reach down. Here it is. Opposite arm from your mover. And rest. Opposite side is coming at us in 10 seconds. Left is mover, right is static. Here we go. And rest. We're going into a static split squat. So forward and back leg, up and down. You may elevate your back foot on a bench, a block, a chair, a table. Here we go. Weight stays neutral between your feet. Fifteen more seconds right here. Tail tucked down to the ground and rest. Here we go, opposite side. Kendall, good job checking in on your hips. Way too good at camouflage. Can't see what I am, I just see what I'm like. About everything that I eat. Feeling myself. 15 more seconds. Jedi level sabotage. Voices in my head make up my entourage. Cause I'm a black belt and I'm beating up on myself. But I'm an expert in coming love to somebody else. And rest. We have 2 more minutes. We have front reverse walking lunges next. So set yourself up in a space that you can travel forwards and backwards in. Here we go. And rest. For the final exercise, we are starting in a kneeling position. We are simply going to stand and return, switching sides every time, and trying not to do what I just did, where I completely kicked my foot out to the side. You're trying to stay as unilateral as possible. Pretend you're between two walls. And you have to lift that knee all the way up. And we are done. Excellent job. You guys are incredible. Rockstars, super proud. Signing off until next time.